Hey, what's up, video editors? It's Premiere Gal here, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to chroma key a green screen shot using the Primat Studio effect in Adobe After Effects. I also want to let you know that if you want to learn something specifically, in my description box below, I leave a time-coded breakdown of each thing that I cover in the tutorial, so if you need to skip ahead, you can certainly do that using the time codes below. Primat Studio is just one part of Continuum by Boris FX. It's known as the Swiss Army knife of plugins because there are so many things you can do with it, from image restoration, extruded text, and more. But in this video, I'm just going to show you how to use the Primat Studio to achieve a professional chroma key in just minutes. Now, before I dive in, I just want to reiterate that Primat Studio is an award-winning software used for compositing in TV shows like Silicon Valley, The Man in the High Castle, in films like Ghostbusters, Spider-Man, Harry Potter, and much, much more. So here we are inside of Adobe After Effects CC, and in my composition, I have this green screenshot of this young woman and a background replacement. I downloaded both of these from Pond5's stock library. In the effects panel, I will search for Primat Studio. Let's drag and drop the BCC Primat Studio onto the green screen footage. Now, the special part about Primat is that it comes with a special user interface, also called the UI, which makes the chroma key process much easier. To start, simply check Auto Analyze. Immediately, the green background is gone and we see the background layer. But because the green screen background wasn't perfectly even, as it rarely is, there are still some highlights and green tints we need to clean up. So let's change it from Final Composite to Matte Status. You can see that there's a whole lot of gray area in the background, and gray is not good because it means it's partly translucent, and we want it to be completely transparent, black. So to fix this, make sure that the clean background is selected. Then just click on the rectangle tool from the UI to highlight areas of gray to remove it, and it turns black. Isn't that easy? Immediately, the gray turns to black. So now let's work on the foreground. We can see that there's gray spots there. So let's clean it. First, select Clean FG, which stands for foreground, and using the rectangle tool, you can select portions of the foreground on the model to remove the gray. You can also zoom in and use the point tool from the UI to get more accurate cleaning. When we zoom out, you will see that some gray has come back to the background, and now this is when it becomes a bit of a battle between the foreground and the background. It's okay to have some gray dots here and there, but you don't want huge spots like we have in the background. To get rid of these big areas, let's use the Outside Mask tool with Mocha Pro, which comes with Continuum. From the dropdown, simply select Mocha Mask, then select the Mocha logo, which will open up Mocha Pro, and here we're going to use the X-Spline tool to draw a mask around that background area. Then hit Save and Close, and now you can see that problem area is gone. So let's change it back to Final Composite, and you can see that there's a slight green spill on the edge of the model. Let's use Spill Sponge to remove areas of green spill. Now I'm going to use the Point tool and simply draw over the green. And then voila, the green is gone. I mean, it's really easy to do. But now around the edges of her hair, you can also see that we lost a bit of detail. So let's restore some of that data. Let's change it back to Matte Status, then click on Restore Detail function and use the Point tool and the Detail Plus tool to just bring back a slight bit of detail. Now notice that it also brought out a slight bit of the background, but no worries, just to fix that, we're going to create another Mocha mask using Mocha Pro around that problem area. So I'm just going to draw another mask using the X-Spline tool and then hit Save. Now let's switch to Final Composite and I'll show you one more tool, Light Wrap. Over in the effects controls, check the box next to Light Wrap. Next, we want to select the background layer we want to grab light information from. Now from the UI, select Light Wrap on black, and here you will just see the light wrap around the model. Now we can adjust the parameters, such as lightness, which will add more white light around the edges. So let's just increase that slightly. We don't want it too much. And then softness is good to use if we want to fill in some lost detail. So I'll increase that to 20. Then width is how wide the wrap is. We don't want it to be too wide, so I'm going to set it to 20. Now let's choose an overlay mode, and it just depends on the scene, but I found that the lighten mode works best in this case. And then let's mix the original at 50% as it gives it more realism. Now let's switch it back to Final Composite, and I'll turn the light wrap feature on and off, and you can see that the light wrap just added a nice little touch of light from the background. As a final touch, I did apply a BCC color balance to the model layer and added 5 points of red back in to counterbalance the green. I hope that you guys enjoyed this introduction to Continuum. There's a lot more to explore, and let me just play it back and hit the effects on and off so you can see what it looked like before and after we applied the Primat Studio. If you want more tutorials that explore Primat Studio's capabilities or any other tools offered in Continuum, give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Be sure to click on my profile photo on the left to subscribe to my channel, and below that you can click on the Patreon page. You can leave me a monthly tip there so I can continue making tutorials like this every month. And then on the right, you can select another tutorial to watch to help you learn something new. Thanks again for watching, stay creative, and I'll see you all very soon.